Hello everybody, and welcome to another episode of The Best Automatic. I'm your host, Captain Pervert.
And I am Captain Gorgeous as well.
Now, there have been some complaints on, well, as you know, well, on the news, as you may notice.
Yes, that every bleeding news channel's been jumping on the bandwagon criticising our popular car show.
Well, not so popular, would say. Well,
yeah, alright, okay. So, we are not condoning violence, even there is violence in our show.
Well, yeah, we can't help that. We have our tame racing driver, and our tame racing driver does help us get gain money. Now, we can't help what our gimp is been watching. He's been watching some bootleg, very popular movie, as we all know, don't we? I mean, it does involve a shopkeeper, don't it?
Oh yeah, in the first one, but in the second one it is completely different, isn't it?
Well, I mean, yes, the news is actually showing these bloody horrific images of what our gimp does. But the shopkeeper ran away, criticised our gimp, and another thing, on our defence, the shopkeeper shot first, so the gimp were protecting itself, even if it was robbing the shop. But we can't help what movie it's been watching. Taxi 2, it might be a bad influence, maybe that's why it's banned.
I mean, a lot of people like the classic, that's why our gimp likes listening to the audio tape in his taxi for making money, isn't it?
So we're going to show you a bit of an example of what our gimp goes through.
May 10th. Thank God for the rain, which has helped wash away the garbage and the trash off the sidewalks. I'm working long hours now. 6 in the afternoon to 6 in the morning, sometimes even 8 in the morning. 6 days a week, sometimes 7 days a week. It's a long hustle, but it keeps me real busy. I can take in 350 a week, sometimes even more when I do it off the meter. All the animals come out at night. Whores, skunk pussies, buggers, queens, fairies, dopers, junkies. Sick, venal. Someday a real rain will come and wash all this scum off the streets. I go all over. I take people to the Bronx, Brooklyn. I take them to Harlem. I don't care. Don't make no difference to me. It does to some. Some won't even take spooks. Don't make no difference to me. 12 hours of work and I still can't sleep. Days go on and on. They don't end. All my life needed was a sense of some place to go. I don't believe that one should devote his life to morbid self-attention. I believe that someone should become a person like other people. I first saw her at Palantine Campaign Headquarters at 63rd and Broadway. She was wearing a white dress. She appeared like an angel out of this filthy mess. She is alone. They cannot touch. Loneliness has followed me my whole life, everywhere. Bars and cars, sidewalks, stores, everywhere. There's no escape. I'm God's lone man. June 8th. My life has taken another turn again. The days move along with regularity, over and over. One day indistinguishable from the next. A long, continuous chain. The idea had been growing in my brain for some time. True force. All the king's men cannot put it back together again. June 29th. I gotta get in shape now. Too much sitting has ruined my body. Too much abuse has gone on for too long. From now on, it'll be 50 push-ups each morning. 50 pull-ups. There'll be no more pills. There'll be no more bad food. No more destroyers of my body. From now on, it'll be total organization. Every muscle must be tight. Listen, you fuckers, you screwheads. Here is a man who would not take it anymore. Who would not let... Listen, you fuckers, you screwheads. Here is a man who would not take it anymore. A man who stood up against the scum, the cunts, the dogs, the filth, the shit. Here is someone who stood up.
That's one thing about Taxi Driver 1. Is I can't understand why the judge let him go, you know what I mean? He commit murder, surely. I mean, I thought he would have got set down for that, but he didn't.
That reminds me, talking about movies. One of our viewers was mentioning about, in our latest episode, about you mentioning that Days of Thunder movie. Not to be confused with Eyes Wide Shut, but it's still very kinky, isn't it?
Yeah, when Nicole Kidman rams it into Tom Cruise, are you doing something on my leg and all that lot? But we do think that she might have used the leg stunt double. I mean, what, how, you know, because obviously we've got that character Harry, haven't we? Whatever Tom Cruise is thinking.
Yeah, it is complicated. You need to see the movie.
That's it now.
No, there's a matter of my volume being turned down when I mentioned about your name, because of you wanted to know why you were called Captain Pervert. It's all because you were adjusting certain items in the Fiat 500 I mentioned.
What? You know.
And another matter, Mussolini you brought up as well about the Fiat. When it was the Topolino Fiat.
What is still classed as a Fiat 500.
Yeah, but I'm used to the familiar one.
We all know that. But if you went out and actually bought the original Fiat 500, the Topolino, what is nicknamed a Mickey Mouse, you know, that is more better than these electric cars. You never mind taking the engine out of that and putting an electric engine in. The fuel capacity of that fuel engine is more better, and you get more mileage compared to an electric one. And with electric prices going up, it's more economical with price.
You're on about petrol cars are better than electric cars then?
Well, Cinchel Chernova, right, he created the Topolino, and he had some great designs of having some helmets taking air, like pumps. The radiator was at the back of the engine, and the petrol tank was on the top.
On top?
Yeah, you know the nose comb of it? That's where the engine was, and all the rest of it is space. So he really made a really confined engine. Giving out all no pumps in it at all. Mass production of it all was brilliant. I mean, that's what people needed.
Well, I won't fancy having an accident in one.
But you won't want one in the, you know, the old kit, the one you like, because the petrol tank's in front of that as well.
So it's like a lawnmower, isn't it? You use gravity.
Yeah, them old lawnmowers, that's right. And they had head-end fan stuff. Like hydraulic brakes, hydraulic suspension and electric windscreen wiper as well. For a 1930s car, this was, it was a really highly advanced,
with a petrol tank on its top,
and it had, it was rear wheel drive, you know, axle on it, so you can imagine how down that's they could do with all the Italians and that.
Right, well, that's my fear I think of.
Well, you got to actually think about your Fiat 500 wouldn't have been created if it weren't for the French. Now, the French, back in 1922, created the Fiat CV. Now, this car was very popular for being called the Lemon Drop. And the reason is because it came in one colour, and one colour only, yellow.
Bleeding neck! It looks familiar.
You mean what?
It looks like that BBC program, Brum.
Well, maybe. I mean, Andre Citroen did create the pedal car based on the Lemon Drop as well. And then there were these Mica cars as well.
They don't look... They're bleeding ache.
You sound bleeding surprised at that, Captain Gorgeous. But that's the true fact. You're all thinking that smart cars is an evolutionary new idea for small cars. Well, you're totally wrong, aren't you? In history, it's the Fiat, right? But it's back way back then, and there's so much history way back.
Yeah, we know history. It's like Henry Ford, isn't it? He espied Mussolini to have the family car, isn't it, with his Model T Ford. So he ain't the first creator of it.
I don't say that, but yeah, all right, you got the idea from America. I mean, he and Mussolini inspired Adolf Hitler. I mean, Hitler's like, oh, what a people's car as well.
Yeah, the VW Beetle was created, wasn't it?
Well, yeah.
I mean, the VW Beetle had so much history to do with the Second World War. It's amazing how that looks so cute and so you think nothing of it.
I mean, maybe that's what then dictators thought of. The cutest your vehicle is. That easily convince people that, oh, there must be a great people to good leadership and they'll have to join their cause for that. Maybe that's why they people said. That's why it's called the people's car. I mean, you look what the French did as well. I mean, they tried to bring their people's car out, but the Second World War stopped them. But they hid their prototypes to make sure Germans didn't find their Citroën CV.
I don't really think the Germans would have been interested in that design. It looks really like a tin metal box. And it got criticised for being upside down pram and that.
I mean, end of the war, it was classic agricultural vehicle, that it was like a farmer's vehicle. And it nearly replaced the tractor.
I mean, that's what we associate with the French with their car, is the Citroën 2CV. We think of Italians, it's the, you know, the Fiat 500 or something else.
Yeah, you know what I'm going to get at. End of the war, the Americans came over, right? And they left these little bikes behind, didn't they?
Yeah, the Cushman, we all know that.
Well, it created the Vespa. Not that Vespa, we're talking the most iconic one of all. Yeah, the bike, right? Because we all know that bike is so much of an iconic for Italy. That's how I associate that thinking of Italy. And that is really the guy what recreated it. I mean, yeah, he might have got all them parts and bits of military equipment from America. But they created their own bike company and started mass producing their own bike. I mean, that got Italy from a pre-war thing. They might have lost the war, but they got mobile. And you think about that, it was a great idea. I mean, you think them bikes have sold all the world around. I mean, it got so popular that, you know, it came like a icon for movies and that.
Don't be daft, movies?
Well, yeah, there's plenty of biker movies with the Vespa.
Like what?
Well, there's this one, you know, Roman Holiday, and then there's Quattrofinia with, Leslie Ash in it.
Oh no, does that mean I have to use the pervert alarm?
No, I'm moving on. I mean, it's like the old true story with the good old Brighty, you know, with the mudders fighting rockers. Or would you actually go in a back alley with Leslie Ash? I mean, that's what I like to think about.
Oh no, pervert alarm!
No, don't be doing that.
No, I have to do that because you're just moving, getting sidetracked. So we need to focus on our plastic bag challenge.
What? Look at that. Turn it off.
Oh, bleeding heck, I have, haven't I? Anyhow, calm down. So, as you've seen on this image, that we are showing the location of the route of the plastic bag challenge. Now, this is where our gimp is going to actually go. Now, this shop is well known for getting robbed by other online players on that classic game, GTA. And you may notice there is some weird form of special effects, or yes, we're trying to distort the image meter down. Now, why are we mentioning this? Well, the thing is, we think of Marty Corsese and he did Taxi Driver. Now, the original one with the violent scene right at the end, now they wouldn't let him have that. They wouldn't even let him have it R-rated. So he desaturated the colour, and this is what we're doing, because we've had so much upsetness about how our gimp actually performs in this task and challenge that he does actually execute shopkeepers.
Yeah, so we can't control the gimp, can we? But the gimp that many people just want our professional driver doing this challenge instead of us. I mean, when we were doing it, we didn't kill the shopkeeper, but the gimp has other ideas. So with our high tech trying to hide and
we're trying to tame it as much as we can, aren't we?
Well, yeah. I mean, we all meant to hide the image of the Fiat 500, because we're establishing it's got a violent history, hasn't it?
Well, yeah, it has, but,
Now, a lot of people have commented about us actually talking through the actual car chase, that it sort of ruins it when we're sort of talking. They like the build up with the music and the police cars all crashing and all that look.
So is that why other people have a different opinion, thinking that we are encouraging violence because we're on this old classic game? What was out over a decade, wasn't it?
Well, yeah, it's one of the oldest GTA games, isn't it? I mean, maybe because it's so popular, because it was the first one online properly, wasn't it? I mean, yeah, there were GTA 4, but how many people really associate going online with that compared to 5?
Well, yeah, so we are coming out with some interesting facts. But we might be talking about the Fiat 500, won't we? About history of it and all that lot.
Well, yeah, but technically, I think we've filled enough of it, haven't we?
Well, yeah, because you start wandering off about talking about Leslie Ash, didn't you?
Oh, yeah.
Well, you're not putting any images on, we're on this scene now, right? So we are watching the game, and we've been told, we got comment about, our game's behaviour really now, isn't it?
Well, I remember when we did this challenge, we've done this route in our vehicles, haven't we? You can't help running over people. I mean, they're in there and bleeding, why aren't they?
Well, as you may notice, that the problem about having special effects, it sort of complicates things, isn't it? That maybe that's where you maybe think you're seeing the same image or the same area over again, because there was some weird glitchiness we had in this, didn't we, when we filmed this chase.
Yeah, I mean, with the second unit on the best automatic, I mean, yeah, it is like filmmaking, isn't it? I mean, you can't predict the weather and stuff and time of day and all that lot. I mean, yeah, we do piece this up all together and all that lot. And the person what did all the, editing and all that lot, we tried our best, didn't we? But we've got these special effects, as we keep saying,
I'm going to have to say it again, aren't we? Because we're trying to really cover our little backsides, you know. Because we are not trying to condone violence. We know Rockstar Games brought out this game. And, we're trying to block out all the blood and all that lot, aren't we?
Well, I'm hoping that will work, won't we?
Well, yeah. So,
I mean, it's like history of this actual game, isn't it? I mean, a lot of solicitors and people criticised that this game was violence. And yeah, it has got violent images and you can do violent acts, but I don't really think that people are stupid enough to actually think they could actually do weird stuff like this. I mean, it's all in a weird pretend world, isn't it? And we are trying to just like say one thing, that yeah, it's got vehicles in, and yeah, this challenge might seem a bit, you know, a bit violent and all that lot, but we were brought up in a generation that we saw black and white police cars crashing all the time in the 70s, didn't we?
Yeah, they were mostly, the car chase movies. I mean, this is the bit where it went a bit weird and glitchy or whatever. You know, the gimp jumping out because the car caught on fire.
I mean, it's strange, innit? I mean, yeah, it's weird that you put effects in. It does a sort of effect that, what we're trying to create.
Really, what we are trying to say that, apologising, aren't we? Because I'm sure it did it again, didn't it? Where the gimp sort of like jumps out or the car leaves him behind.
Yeah, and it caught on fire, didn't it?
Well, yeah, it's weird, isn't it? But yeah, that's what happens when you're trying to do effects. And as we are explaining, we're doing these effects because
that the laptop blew that car up.
Yeah, well, I was trying to mention the...
We've already mentioned about, Marty Corsese.
That's his name, my friend. Well, we're all getting back with Taxi Driver because with our team racing driver, driving a taxi in this game, because you can do that, and obviously it's seen the other movie, what got banned or something. No Robert De Niro in Taxi Driver 2, is there?
No, I don't know. I mean, the first one's like something to do with the anger and the loneliness what most young men go through. I mean, you could establish maybe the psychology of this vintage game used to do with online players. At least it brought online players together and they could communicate and talk to each other and got rid of that loneliness.
Yeah, but it's condoning violence.
Well, yeah, but people have a different opinions.
Like what?
Well, a lot of people think that Grand Theft Auto is, that classic game.
Yeah, we all know, we've been watching the footage.
Is mostly for men, young men, or, well, really young men. They associate that they're always on it. But it's like everyone associates the image of the Fiat 500. Little cute car. It's got to be a girl's car, isn't it? I mean, that's what they rubbed it in back in the old days. That small cars are all designed for ladies because they're smaller. But we all know that there's great fun in small little hatch vehicles. You know, they're nippy, they're fast, and you can do them bright turns, really got in them and all that lot.
What are you suggesting then?
Well, the stigma is that, Tom's got to move on there. I mean, alright, somehow these dictators created the image of the people's car. They didn't say they put them in categories that little small cars are for ladies. They sort of like, used it, it's a people's car. So we don't know where this stigma came from, the way the Fiat 500 is specifically made for ladies.
And on that note, I think we should move off on this subject, don't you think?
So,
his excuse for saying all that is,
I was saying something, you just interrupted.
I know, but your reason you mentioned all this with ladies and all that lot, because you're small, and that's why. So, the note is, on the cheesy crumpet, lemon flavoured crumpet, it's time to end the show.
You can't be saying that.
Already have.